Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party. How's everybody doing? Hope you're good. I'm great. Is this in focus? I can't really tell. It's a beautiful day, kind of. It's actually pretty cold and cloudy, but that's great for filming. In front of me over here, I have this interesting basket. I've used this for a few years now. It's a compressed fibrous basket, has holes on multiple levels. Usually people use these for things like strawberries, or like you can fill them up with a whole bunch of impatiens and have like a big just ball of flowers. It looks really pretty when you do that. And that's what I've done in the past. So I've put little sunimpatiens in this and just had a big ball of flowers. I'm going to do something a little bit different this year. Over here, I have a lot of plants laid out. Not just down there, but they're over here too. That's not all gonna fit in here. But the idea here is that I wanted to have a whole bunch of supertunia vistas in this with a bunch of color and texture in the top. Texture-wise, I don't really have a lot of grasses and things like that, so I'm gonna kind of wing it up top. But I have a pretty good idea of what I want to do down here. I've already got this filled up to the first row with potting soil. The thing with these types of baskets, these layered baskets, is that you're working kind of in a reverse order. Normally in a hanging basket, I would go ahead and get my nice tall plants, my thrillers and fillers up in the top, and then I'd work my spillers around the edge. When planting these up with things that start down low and you're working your way up, that's when I have to sort of reverse my thinking a little bit. Here are some of the plants that I want to work with as my spillers. I have supertunia vista bubblegum here, supertunia vista silverberry right over here to the side, and I have some purple wave petunias that I think would look nice in this combination here with the pink and the white and everything. I know it's hard to, just have to trust me. But the thing is, supertunia vista bubblegum and supertunia vista silverberry, they're probably the most vigorous of all the proven winners petunias, at least from my experience. And there's 8 holes in here. There's no reason to that. You can do a 12-inch hanging basket with just one of these petunias. And I think having 8 of them, it would be overkill. Like, they would end up just choking each other out. So I kind of have to rethink how I'm going to space things out a little bit. And that's where the wave petunias come in, because they don't get as big. They're not as vigorous. So I figure that alternating those around will help kind of open up some space a little bit in between the really big, vigorous. You could even say aggressive. That's what they are. They're aggressive plants. They fill in a space so quickly. So that's kind of the plan there. Just kind of alternating things around and then using those purple wave petunias as sort of a breaker in between things. The tricky part here is these are the pots on the supertunias. And that's you see that hole? Yeah. So I will have to really get in here and take these roots apart very, very, very carefully and loosely. I'll try and maintain as much root as I can, but they're gonna have to go through a little bit of recovery. That's okay though. These are really tough plants. Yeah, you can see here, really worked a lot of the soil out of those roots. So they're gonna have to take some time to recover. This is actually good timing for that. The weather is very mild right now. We're supposed to have a lot of rain the next few days. It's going to help out immensely with getting these going and having them recover from this. It also helps to make sure that that root ball is slightly moistened so that the roots aren't very tender. They're not going to break apart as easily, and just gently and slowly work them through the edge there. For the first row, I'm doing 2 of the supertunia vista bubblegums, and then I am going to tuck in a purple wave petunia also on each side, and then I'm going to add some more soil in here, bringing it on up to the next layer of holes, and then tuck in a couple of the supertunia vista silverberries, and then a couple more of the supertunia vista bubblegums. I want the vista bubblegum to be the main petunia in here, partially because there's an abundance of them. Plants are a little bit harder to come by right now. Everybody's out gardening with, you know, everything going on right now, and that's fantastic. The silverberries, I have some other things I want to do with, and I just want those in there more as an accent. Where this is going to hang, it's near a light. That'll help illuminate things a little bit at nighttime. These purple wave petunias that I've put in between them, they may not stand a chance, because like I said, these other supertunias that are in here, the vistas, aggressive growers. So what I decided to do was, instead of alternating them all the way through, that I would tuck some more in around the top. I think they'll have better odds that way if they're up high as opposed to intermingling with these petunias. Make sure to go ahead and do that as I start throwing my fillers in here, which is what I'm gonna do right now. And I'm gonna have to think well about it because there's a lot of plants I wanna tuck up here, but not that much space. Do know I have this sunimpatien. It's the compact tropical rose. It is a beautiful sunimpatien. The variegation on these is really intense, and sometimes it's so extreme that it's almost like the leopard print or cheetah print of flowers, just in the sense that whatever you put around these, they don't really stand out. This is what takes all the attention, but I love the color of the flowers so much that I'm willing to go ahead and put them in here anyways. You can kind of see the growth on this one's a little bit wonky. I had it sitting more in a shaded spot because it was so ready to come out of its container that it was requiring a lot of water, so I moved it into the shade, but that made it come out a little bit. That's okay. Here I have a pentas. A pentas doesn't want to be on camera right now. I'll back things up so you can see it a little bit better. This variety is called Butterfly Pink. The pollinators absolutely love these. Isn't that pretty? Okay, this is a colocasia Hawaiian punch. I'm actually going to just pop this right here in the center. That's going to grow up and over everything. Here's a picture of what those look like. I don't think that this is typically how they look. This is one of the like three pictures I see everywhere for them. And then when I see more honest pictures, they just have kind of a pretty red stem. Not necessarily this rainbow of tropical color, but I don't know. We will see. I'm not trying to call this company liars, but I don't see many pictures with them being this colorful, but I see lots of pictures of them with just red stems. And the red stems are beautiful. I'm going to keep that in there just a smidge higher than I normally would because it's going to need some sun to get going. You can see it's pretty shaded in here, but it already has a start on it. If it didn't have a start, I would go ahead and put it in a pot, wait a couple weeks for it to get going, and then work it in here. But since it's already going, it should be okay. I thought about maybe putting a coleus in here, which I might still do, but I do want to go ahead and remember to get some plants in on the sides. Like, I want to alternate some of the lobularia. This is the snow princess alyssum. The smell is so fantastic. This is going to be near a door and a window, and I absolutely love being able to crack the windows open in the morning and smell the alyssum in the house. It's so intoxicatingly sweet and fragrant. I know I'm going to want at least two of those in here. This is just me mocking things up now. That's kind of how my brain works. Sometimes I'll just start to gently lay things in place and get an idea of how I like the balance and the colors together. The alyssum I know isn't really going to go all that well with everything that's in here, but I don't care because it smells so good. I'm using it anyways. So I'm gonna make sure to keep the alyssum up here in this gap above that wave petunia, and then the other waves I'll put above the other ones. Oh, this one has some roots on it. That is a very strong petunia. That was another thing I wanted to note as far as scent goes. These purple wave petunias, they don't have a name. They just sent them as assorted, but they smell fantastic. Usually purple petunias of any variety I've noticed have a good amount of fragrance to them, and this just, it's one of my favorite smells. I'm wanting to make sure that I have those up top with these lobularias here, which are looking a little bit rough. We'll talk about that in a minute. The pentas up top, the sunimpatien in the middle. By the way, sunimpatiens, they don't video well. That's not anywhere near as ridiculous looking in person as it is on camera, I promise. I had also thought about tucking in some of the dusty millers, but really, there's no room. That sunimpatien alone will fill in the top of this and will require some pruning and some maintenance to keep it from overcrowding everything. So putting more in there with it just doesn't really make sense. Although I do think that this is a very pretty pairing. I like those together, but it also doesn't really match the top. Kind of have like a mullet planter going on here. Like, there's a lot of pink and wildness going on up top, and then things are a little bit more sweet and subtle down below, the pinks, purples, and whites. That's okay. I'm fine with it. Look at this glorious masterpiece. Now, I know, things take time. I had to do a lot of pruning on the roots to get some of these plants in here, and that's okay. That's just kind of the nature of the beast when you're planting into these little holes, unless you can find your plants in little six packs. But the petunias, like supertunias, you don't normally or actually ever find those in small six packs. They always come in, like, you know, one of these guys. Nice big pot, which is fantastic, but they don't coming, the little plugs. But they'll be okay. I'm going to make sure to keep this entire thing consistently moist, and I'm going to place it for a couple of weeks in a part shade. It'll get some morning sun and it'll be filtered throughout the rest of the day. That's just so that these plants have some time to go ahead and put their roots back out and adjust to things. If I were to take this and put it right into the sun, even though everything that's in this can take full sun with no problem at all, it would be too much for them because they need to have the root mass to support the foliage. So they'll need a couple weeks to bounce back from that. There is a good amount of continuous release fertilizer in here as well. Petunias are very heavy feeders. Throughout the growing season, this will get watered, or not watered, it'll be watered consistently. I'm going to have this on drip, but it will be fertilized weekly. It really makes a big difference with petunias and their vigor, and also to help out with any issues sometimes with like yellowing foliage and things like that, to have a nice balanced fertilizer that has a good amount of potassium in it. Petunias really like a lot of potassium, but something that will help keep that foliage from starting to fade out, because when they're in a hanging basket in direct sun, that can be a little bit more tricky for them. Now, I've never tried the supertunias in a situation like this. I've had them spill over the edges of hanging baskets before, but I even have to wonder if they might be so vigorous that like they may not even be able to support all that. We'll have to wait and see. This is somewhat experimental, which is why I was just kind of like, yeah, I'm just going to plant this up and have fun with it. Yeah, the purple wave that's in there, though, I don't know if we'll be able to see that come July. Maybe, I don't know. And that's why I wanted to make sure to have some of them planted up top, and because it was really important to me to make sure that those are in here with the lobularia, the alyssum, to have that nice sweet fragrance. It's going to be so nice walking out the door to the patio and just having that waft of the sweet smell from the alyssum and those petunias be very inviting. And like I said, it's going to be so nice in the morning to have the windows cracked and smell that in the kitchen. Ugh. I can't wait. I'm so excited to get this hung up by my door. The pentas that's in the back, like I said, that variety is called Butterfly Pink. Pentas normally only grow like 10 to 18 inches. So if I hadn't been able to find one that was already a good size, I wouldn't have done this, because the sun patient that's in here will choke that out completely if it were any smaller. But this one's already at least 10 inches, probably more like 12 inches. So it's going to get to be a good size, and I, like I said, I'll have to do a cutback on the sunimpatien probably midsummer, but that's okay. That helps keep them looking a little bit more tidy anyways. And I like the contrast between the shapes of the flowers and just having some darker foliage back there. I'm hoping that that will balance out the chaos of the variegation on the sunimpatien. Even though I love the sunimpatien, the tropical rose, the variegated one, like I said, it's a very loud plant, and it tends to be like the main focus of pretty much anything that's around it. And there's a decent amount more I could have done with this for texture, like some diamond frost euphorbia, something like that, coleus, but that sunimpatien, it's going to be vigorous enough that I think I need to just leave some space up there. And then there's that colocasia that's in there too. That's going to come up above everything over the next several weeks. I'd say come, you know, the start of summer, late June, that should be up above everything, and it will have those nice red stems that go well with the red stems here on the sunimpatien, and then the pink with the flowers. I think that will be pretty, and then there's more pink continuing down the rest of it. I do have some other hanging baskets I will be doing that will be more uniform than this. And I mean, I don't think that the contrast is all that bad between everything, really. I like it together, but I know that it may not be everybody's cup of tea. You know, usually you see these kinds of colors together down below, and you imagine something a little bit more subtle and calm up top. But that's not really the vibe I was feeling today. So I was feeling chaos plus some balance. The alyssum that's in here, you see all the yellowing foliage on there. I've noticed with alyssum, with the lobularias, they don't hang on in their nursery containers very long. It's one of those plants where when I bring them home, it's best to get them planted within a couple weeks, because it after like 3 weeks or so, they just don't look good. So I've had those for about a month, and that's why they look like that, but it's okay. They'll fill back out. They'll drop that yellowing foliage and start to bush out and look pretty. Just like these over here do. They're really just lovely, beautiful plants that smell fantastic. There is a slight possibility that I might pluck these wave petunias out of the sides there and throw in a sweet potato vine. Because the thing with the sweet potato vines is they have a tuber, and it's nice and firm. So normally once you have something like this potted up, whatever's right there, you'd have to take the whole thing apart to get something new in there. But with the sweet potato vines, if you can get that tuber, you can usually, I probably have to remove some of the foliage, but I could probably just pluck it onto that hole And I think that that would kind of bring the top and bottom together a little bit. The sweet potato vines haven't come in yet, so I'm not able to do that. And I kind of like this idea of being able to see how that looks. Okay, that's all. Thanks for hanging out while I toss this little ball of colorful chaos together. Very sweet, fragrant, colorful ball of chaos. I hope everybody's doing well. I have all my, you know, the YouTube stuff down below. I use Instagram more than anything else. I will be, as this starts to fill back out and look better, there will be updates on there. And then in future garden tours, so stay tuned for those. Time for me to go. It's supposed to rain all week, so I got a lot of planting to do today. Of course! As always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye-bye.